Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Hey guys, what's good? What's popping? Today I will be making a video about a makeup trend that I saw on TikTok. There were a bunch of girls who were doing this thing where they started doing the makeup by using their concealer first and then their foundation. And first I found it weird, then I found it fascinating, and I was like, okay, you know what, I will try to see how this is going to look on me, if I can pull it off. I don't know, because to me it's kind of weird to change the, how do you say, to change the order of doing makeup, kind of. But I just want to give it a try and see how this is gonna turn out. This video is going to be a voiceover. It's gonna be my very first one because I just want to be doing my makeup in peace while telling y'all what I'm doing, what I'm using, and then we're just gonna see at the end if I'm gonna look like a fool or not. So if you're interested in seeing how this is gonna turn out, keep watching, and without further ado, let's get on into this video.
Okay, let's go. First of all, I'm going to take this hair out of my face so that I can do my makeup properly. Then I am going to use the NYX Shine Color Primer and put it all over my face and really rub it in. Then I'm going to do my eyebrows, brush them a little bit before I use the Essence Long Lasting Eye Pencil in the shade 02 Hot Chocolate for my eyebrows. And I'm going to line the shade of my eyebrows and then I'm going to fill it in as well. Me and my eyebrows really have a love-hate relationship, so this is going to take a little while. Now I'm using the Can't Stop Won't Stop concealer from NYX to clean up my eyebrows. I know mine is empty, but I have another one in stock. Of course, I'm going to blend the concealer out and I'm just gonna use the brush that I used to clean my eyebrows. Not bad. I'm going to take the exact same concealer to put it all over my eyelids, and then I'm just gonna take my beauty blender to just blend the concealer out and all over my eyelids. To set the concealer, I'm going to use no other setting powder than the Sasha Buttercup setting powder. One of my favorites, I love it. Putting it up my little brush and then putting it all over my eyelid.
I
I don't let it set for too long before I brush it all away. And then I'm going to use the Makeup Revolution Pro HD Amplified 35 palette, and the name of this palette is Social Light. I'm gonna start with a darker shade and put it all over my crease. And then I'm taking a lighter pinkish shade and put it on my lid. Blending these colors together so there are not any harsh lines, because this is exactly what we don't want, right? These are the same two colors that I always use, and I forgot to show you that in the beginning before I started, but these are the colors that I use. Moving on to the reverse highlighting slash contouring, and I'm going to highlight the exact same places I always highlight. So under my eyes, on my nose, on my chin, and also under my nose. And then I'm just going to take my beauty blender and blend, blend, blend. After I am done with that, I will take the Yves Saint Laurent All Hours foundation and use it as a contour. It's in the shade B90. It was a present actually, but the person who gave it to me bought the wrong shade, so I'm just using it as a contour. I would never buy such expensive contour, to be honest. And that will also blend with the bottom of my beauty blender. I really do take my time when I blend though, because I do not want it to look crazy. Even though at this point, I really felt like I'm looking crazy. But we will see how this is going to look at the end. So the next step is to put my foundation over all my highlights and contour. And I'm going to use the NYX Can't Stop, Won't Stop Full Coverage Foundation. I know I use a lot of NYX. This is not sponsored. I'm not that far yet. But I just love the brand, so I use everything from there. The shade of my foundation is number 17, Cappuccino. So I'm just blending this all over my face. I really felt weird, and I feel like I have really been doing no work, and that all the work that I did underneath my foundation is just gone. But I'm trusting the process, because this is what I'm told to do, so I'm just gonna do it. Afterwards, I'm taking my setting powder and putting it all over the places that I highlighted before. So under my eyes, on the bridge of my nose, etc. Once I dusted the powder off, I'm going to use some powder for my contour. I don't remember how the powder is exactly called. I just know that it is from Sleek, but I will look for it, and once I find it, I will link it in the description box, just like I'm going to link every other product that I used in this video. using some more setting powder for the cheekbones. Moving on to the eyeliner. Me and eyeliner, we also have like a love-hate relationship. Sometimes it turns out good, sometimes it doesn't. I really struggle with doing my eyeliner and having them look the same way, but I just try. Okay, I was alright with how this looked. It was fine. So dusting off the rest of the setting powder, and then I'm basically done with my face. Now it's time for the eyelashes, but I will do that off camera because I can never do that in front of a camera to save my life. I need a lot of concentration, I need a lot of time. So I'll be right back. There we go. So I'm just going to use some mascara on my lower lashes. And then it's time for some highlighter, and I'm using from Pixi the Beauty Blush Duo in the shade Peach Honey. Moving on to my lips. To line my lips, I also use the eye pencil from Essence in the shade Hot Chocolate, but of course I use a different one, and I just line my lips with them. And then I take the NYX Liquid Suede, I hope you say it like that. It's the cream lipstick in the shade 07 Sandstorm, and put it all over my lips. On top of that, I use the MAC Cream Sheen Glass in the shade Partial to Pink and put it on top. The last step is to put some setting spray on my face, and of course I'm using no other setting spray but from NYX, and it's the matte finish setting spray that I love and that I will forever use, and I use a lot because I want my makeup to be perfect all day. So, and we're done.
This is the finished look. I have to say, it is really not bad. It is very, very nice. When I look at my, I have the mirror down here, so I'm looking down. I think I did pretty good. I think I can be proud of myself. I did really good. It was weird in the beginning because I really felt like at the point where I was putting the foundation over the concealer, I thought that you can not really see what's under there. But it turned out really fine with everything going on later on, so I'm good. I'm fine. I'm happy with how I look. Let me know what you think about my look, about this trend, about the order of doing concealer first and then foundation. And yeah, this is the end of the video. Thank you so much for watching. Please like, subscribe, comment. You know what you gotta do. Follow me on all my social media for more videos. Let me know what you want to see me do next. And then I would just say, I'll see you in the next video.